Okay, so the Spidermaf RP2040. Played with this, enjoyed messing about with this and getting the demo disc that Blue Scuzzy put online running on a Mac 128 emulator. Great fun, and I know some of you have bought the boards off me. Also, well, I hope you've enjoyed doing the same thing, but quite a cool little device. Anyway, I got one of these as well. So this is just a standard module that you can get for a couple of pounds. This is an SD card reader, or a micro SD card reader anyway. When we built this, when I built the firmware, I told the firmware to use the internal flash for the drive image. But look what I found on the instructions. Okay, so here's the bit where you're setting up the ROM and you're setting up the disk image. And it says when using an internal disk image, then do that. So there's the UMAC disk. And then it says if using SD and if you do not want an internal image. So does this mean that you can use an external image on one of these at the same time as you can use the internal image? So that's the experiment for today. So if I look at this, where's the bit about the setup? Yeah, it says here that we need to set these things up for changing the input and output pin from this SD card. But I thought, well, I didn't add those at compile time, so I needed to recompile, but I don't know whether I do or not, because it says the GPIOs default to SPI NOR running on pins 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, I think if we look at this, we should have pins 2, 3, 4, 5 there. We're not using them for anything else, are we? I think 0 and 1 is something else, but I reckon we've got all of the pins there. So what I'm going to do today is to experiment wiring those up. Don't need to do a lot of wiring. All right, so if I zoom in on this, the first pin here is cable select. So that will be pin 5 on this, and then system clock, that's easy, and then Mozzie and Mozzie out and Mizo, I think that's in and out. It says TX and RX on these instructions, so I'm sort of hoping that this is the right interface, or you know, that I haven't picked up the wrong interface for it. But anyway, so I'm going to wire this up, so you can watch me doing that if you want, but I'm probably going to fast forward it. Okay, so I bought a couple of these, so I've got them spare. They're not that expensive. I'm not sure whether Mozzie is the same as, well, I don't know, what's Mozzie? It's S2C, isn't it? No, it's not I2C. I don't know. Let me know in the comments. Tell me what Mozzie and Miso actually stand for. But I'm going to say it's TX and RX, and let's see what happens. It's an experiment, might not work. And I'm definitely going to be using Zing Wang, not a sponsor. Maybe if I solder it to the bottom, I won't completely waste it, and it might be recoverable. Okay, that looks a bit neat. Pleased with that. It's only temporary, but it's gone on quite well, actually. I was a bit worried because these would be a heat sink that was wick the heat away, but seems to be all right. Okay, I've just got the laptop out again to check the wiring. Obviously, we know where the power is going. It's the first two there, is ground and 5 volts is the first one. I'm assuming this is 5 volts. Doesn't actually say. Let's hope it's not 12 volts. These top pins here are in the right order. So which one is going to be pin 5? It's the one right opposite the reset. So let's just pop a bit of solder there. Now I'm only soldering the top of this really, but so that's pin 5. And then the rest of them go down. What is it? Yeah, 5, 4, 3, 2. All right, so 5, 4, 3, 2, okay. So the cable select was number 5. So he can go on to begin with, that's easy. we know where that is. So cable select on 5. RX is next, so if it's receiving, then let's say in and out. So I'm going to say that's yellow. Yeah, so it might actually wire up exactly right at this. So that's yellow, next. So then green, and then blue is the last one, should be system clock. So is that system clock? Yeah, okay. So it's wired up the same way, which is nice. To make it easier if you want to modify this board and add a socket for it, which I might do at another time. Okay, so I just found a reference to this, and it seems to imply power supply 4 to 5 or 3.3 volts. So let's just bung 5 volts into it and see whether I regret it. Ouch, that got me. So the top was 5 volts and then the next one down was ground, if I remember correctly. Do that. Okay, so that's all wired up, not the neatest, but you know what's coming in a future video, don't you? Well, that's if this works anyway. So I think that's wired up correctly. Let's bung some power into this now. And let's see whether the telltale still flashes. Yeah, it's a bit hidden. And it doesn't look like there's any LEDs on that. Is this getting hot? It doesn't seem to be. All right, so let's wire this up and see whether there's any output on it. Actually, you know, the thing I ought to do first is work out how to burn something to an SD card. So I'll get an SD card. Okay, let's just set the Mac running while I'm here. And I've got these Lexar things and the oldest ever pair of scissors. All right, I can't believe I'm using 32 gig for this. How many times 32 gig storage I'm putting on 128k emulation. All right, let's pop that in there and let's just read back what we have to do. Disk image, if using an SD card, use a fat formatted card. I mean, who knows, will it even read 32 gigs? I mean, it doesn't say, does it? All right, so umac 0 image is what I need to put on there. I've got SD card formatter, don't even know whether this I might be able to format this in FAT. Let's just see what happens. It might let me. All right, so have I got some other demo disks? So on here he says, grab a system disk from here. So this is just system software. Loads of different versions. Wonder if we just do a system 3.1 disk, wasn't it? Let's try that one. All right, paste that on there. Oh, that's 7-zip anyway, so I've got to... I need to unzip that. Hopefully it'll unzip onto a FAT drive. Let's delete that. UMAC 0 image. Drive. Okay, so let's eject that and put it into this beast. Wait to make sure it's finished. Now I don't know whether I should try and hot swap this, but I mean, let's just try it. I mean, is this even the right way around? I'm not sure. They tend to tell you with feel if it's the wrong way. Okay, so that's the disc in there. Is anything happening? I don't even know whether it would sense that there was a new disc gone in there. Not sure. So let's reset it. Doing its memory check. Checking all those DRAMs on the non-existent DRAM board. Oh no, Pico Micro Mac. No, it's not working. So, I mean, why isn't that working? Well, there's so many different things that could be wrong on this, aren't there? So somebody said before, they sense the defeat in my voice. And then other people said, hey, you salad fingers, which I'm not. Anyway, wrong dialect. So this experiment didn't work today. What could be wrong? Well, that disc could be too big. So I think the next thing I need to do is find a much, much smaller disc. Maybe format it on the PC as well. And then another thing is that this reader might not be right. I don't know whether Muzzy and Muzzy and Mizzo are actually in and out. So, I mean, it might be a good idea to change those round, but I don't think it's that. I don't think it's that. Or it might just be that Micromac can't handle two discs at once. So if you have any luck with this, if you want to do the same thing, if you've done it, please let me know in the comments. Please let me know if you saw that I'd done anything wrong, and then hopefully I'll be able to release a video in a couple of weeks with a solution to this and get this working, and then we can have a go at maybe designing a board with an SD reader on it directly, or just the pins to put this one in there, and let's see how that goes. All right, if you enjoyed this video, just an experimental video again, please like and subscribe it. Please let me know what you hated about it, if you want. But the only other thing I can say is bye. Oh, new merch. It's had a good life. Vinyl as well.